Dear friends, together, let us acknowledge our failure to love this world as Jesus does. Holy One,
we confess that we are not awake for you. We are not faithful in using your gifts. We forget the least of our siblings. We do not see your beautiful image in one another. We are infected by sin that holds our community. Open our hearts to your coming. Open our eyes to see you in our neighbor. Open our hands to serve your creation. Amen.
Beloved of God, may we know this good news for you, that we are God's children, and Jesus, our beloved, opens the doors to us. And it is through Jesus that you are forgiven. By Jesus, you are welcomed. In Jesus, you are called to rejoice. Let us live in the promises prepared for us from the foundation of the world. Amen. Another invitation for you to join in with our prayer of the day. O God of justice and love,
you illumine our way through life with the words of your Son. Give us the light we need and awaken us to the needs of others. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Step to roll out of bed. And then we gotta get dressed. Can you be kind? Can you be helpers? Can you bring joy to people? I know these little ones bring joy to people. Look, I just saw you share. Way to go. Sharing is hard when we're little sometimes, especially when it's first. Yeah, way to go, cousins. Huh. We are going to learn more today in our story about Jesus asking us to be prepared. We're going to talk more about what that means. And so, we practice one of those ways that we named, let's practice praying. So, let's repeat after me. Let's do a repeat after me prayer. So, if you put your hands together or open, eyes open or eyes closed, however you want, and let's pray. Dear God, thank you for today.
Thank you for
my family.
Thank you for my friends.
Thank you for my friends.
Help me
to make the world
better
for us.
Amen.
Get back to your seats. I do have a treat. There's a variety of treats. I'll let the parents choose for younger ones and older kids who know how to choose, they choose. Drew Wayne, you can come in. Make sure. All right, anybody who wants to, we're willing to be able to stand for our gospel proclamation. I grew up in Albuquerque, Mexico. So that was quite a journey. young adult mind. I could surprise my family. Surprise them. I could go see them. We're preparing for Thanksgiving. So I have time off. I was so proud of myself because I had never bought my own airline tickets before. That was a new thing for me too. So here I am, getting my laptop, finding my flights. I didn't know what flying between multiple stops meant, but I think for a very long trip. But I bought the tickets and I got there. Well, before my last leg of the trip, because I had 3 connecting flights. Yeah, that was when there was lots of multiple flight stops. And so Virginia to Chicago to Colorado, then finally all of the places. Well, I started to think that last leg of the trip, maybe I should let someone know that I'm coming. Because what if I get there and no one's there? But what if I get there and the door's locked and there's no way, because I don't have my house key anymore. I mean, yes, I have no ways to break into my parents' house, but that aside, I don't want to do that. So I called my dad. And I was like, Dad, I'm going to keep him secret. He was really good at keeping a straight face. He could keep a straight face like no one else in our family. So he was in on it. He said, okay, that's awesome. You're coming to join. Oh my goodness, everyone's going to be so excited. Are you sure you don't want to tell your mother? Are you sure? No, it's going to be a big surprise. She's going to love it. It's going to be amazing. She's going to be overjoyed. The whole family's going to be together. Oh, it's going to be a great Thanksgiving surprise. So, I get home. My dad perfectly made up excuses so he did not go run the errands. He was home. He opened the door, let me in, helped me hide my luggage in my old bedroom. And we just waited. We're waiting for everyone to come home. I hear the garage door open because my parents live in a house where the garage was attached. And you could hear it. I knew this was the moment. So their pantry is right off of where the garage entrance is. So I'm going to hide in the pantry. Perfect. You jump out. Surprise. So I do that. I get in the pantry. I'm hiding there, silently waiting. My dad playing his part. My sisters just rush by, go to their rooms, do their thing. My mom's unpacking the groceries. I heard my mom talking about getting all ready for Thanksgiving, all of those things. Here it is. Here's the moment. I hear the door handle starts to rattle. She's gonna open the pantry. She's gonna see the joy in both of our faces. So exciting. Surprise, Mom! She opens the door. Right away, she slams it right in my face. I'm pretty sure there was some explicit language shouted out loud, and then she calmly opened the door again. Greeted me with a lecture. With also tears and a giant hug. She was so excited, but I think I almost killed my mother during the surprise. She was recovering from the shock of it, but she was so glad that I came. But I also heard, right, when you know when your parents start bringing out your whole entire full name, Jennifer Lynn, and was talking about, I haven't done my hair, I haven't cleaned the house, there's a bunch of dust in your room, and on and on and on about all these things. How could I not tell her the house was so in disarray and she did not know I was coming? Love. And those are those moments that are great when we be mindful, sharing lessons about Jesus and God. Now, in the first letter to the Thessalonians, Paul wrote that the Lord's returning is near. And so, Christians at the time, they literally took that word. They were like, okay, we're ready. Jesus is coming. Started talking about some of those with the kids. Provide for those who experience homelessness or we are at this morning. But know this, the peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Bless you.
Thank you. on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Share the meal. As you break bread or crackers, may you know this is the body
Emceeing the events is T. Michael Randall.
A local actor and singer. We also have David Wright from St. Louis, Missouri, who's a music historian and knows all about the African American roots of barbershop singing. And also from Toronto, Cole Fields, who is an educator and arranger of music. So we're having on Saturday an event that looks at this history of African American roots in barbershop singing, and Bruce Henry and his band are playing samples of the development of African American music in America. And then on Sunday at 3 o'clock,
there's a concert, but also with Bruce Henry and his band, Great American Unity Chorus, and Noel Minneapolis. That's a youth choir from North Minneapolis here, an additional youth choir, very good, are putting on a show at 3 o'clock. This is all at the Capri Theater here in North Minneapolis. The event on Saturday is free. The event on Sunday is pay as you can. We've got a generous grant from the Minnesota State Arts Board to support this, so it's very important. And but you do have to purchase tickets. Could be sold out, so I encourage you to get tickets ahead of time. But this coming Saturday,
events from
GNU Sings.com or just look at Great Northern Union or Roots Revision.
Who claims us?